This family of Aranda Kadich women have been living with type 2 diabetes for years. They all have family affected by the condition.
It's an epidemic, I believe, with all our young people getting diagnosed so young.
We've had a few family members who've been on dialysis through diabetes.
All of my mum's side family are diabetic.
They work hard to manage their diabetes. Living in Alice Springs, they do have access to healthy food and medical services. But for people in remote communities, overcrowding and poor living conditions have fuelled an explosion of the disease.
We know that the ongoing social disparities experienced by many Aboriginal people living in remote communities are contributing to the diabetes epidemic.
Menzies researchers studied 7 years of health data from 21,000 Aboriginal people across more than 50 remote communities. They found 29% of adults have type 2 diabetes. In Central Australia, it's a staggering 40%. The epidemic now spreading to children.
And we're seeing cases down as young as people aged 4 having type 2 diabetes and obesity already.
Dr. Hare says current health strategies are not working and things need to change.
I think that the challenge is providing culturally safe care where people feel that they can talk freely about their condition with one another, access the supports that they need.
A view echoed by those living with the condition every day.
And the information is there, but we just need to bring it out more and break down that stigma.
Talk to the people and do what they want to do, not what you tell them to do.
A silent killer that's now an epidemic. Michael Park, SBS World News.